Hello, I'm Andrew, and today I'm going to review this JBL's TI-600. And as you can see, I made a setup next to my television, and I bought these things very cheap, and that's why I bought them. And I think, okay, this is my chance to review my first JBL speakers, and these speakers were about €900 in 1989, and they are 110 centimeters tall. They are very tall, big, tall speakers, and they weigh 21 kilo a piece. And if you want to hear the sound of these things, you just go to my other video where I tested speaker cables, very expensive speaker cables and very cheap speaker cables, and I make a sound test so you can hear the difference, and there you can hear these speakers very good. So this test is not about the sound. If you want to hear the sound of these speakers, just go to my other test, this cable test, the Royal Yade test, and you will hear the sound of these speakers. To be honest, I thought very much about this, because I thought that these speakers are very massive speakers, and I thought they were good, and they could maybe, well, I have these magnets for already, you see them on the stand, I have them already too long, and I want to change, but these speakers don't even come close. They sound very good, but completely different. Maybe it is because of my ears. I used to this old Magnat style, because not everybody loves the sound of Magnat, the vintage Magnat. I mean, the all ribbon technique Magnats. And these speakers, they look nice. They look terrific. Strong 21 kilo speakers. And well, I got these very cheap because, as you can see, they are not very nice. The speaker itself is in perfect condition. The wood is not damaged, and only the fronts are damaged. But, and I don't know, normally you have wood, you can see, you can just easily repair the cloth on it, but this is glued, so I don't know if it will be an easy job. But what I like from these fronts is that they are metal. As you can see, these things are metal. I will show you. So they cannot break off like plastic. Most of these fronts, when you have problems, the plastic is broken, so you cannot put the thing back like it have to be. And these are metal. The frame is metal, so it's more stronger, impossible to break. And let me show you the back side of these speakers. Okay, here we have the back side, completely from the top till the bottom. As you can see, it have one bass port on top and one completely on the bottom. And here it is standing that it is made in Denmark, JBL, yeah, and the serial number, and of course the B-wire connection. That's a nice option, the B-wire connection. And as you can see, the wood is pretty thick, that's why I think it have a weight from 21 kilo a piece. They are pretty heavy speakers, you know. And last month I had a Jamo 160, E160, and these things, well, they were so light, I think 7-8 kilo, and the sound was terrible. These JBLs sounds good, but I will not change these old Magnats, the 05s, for these speakers. Really, I wouldn't, because, well, I just love my Magnat sound. And I don't say this is a bad sound, but there is a little bit bass. I miss some bass. These speakers start at 40 hertz. My Jamo start at 30 Hertz. And 10 Hertz is a very big difference. And yeah, you can and also the highs. The highs are not so sharp as in my Magnats, but some people do not like the highs of the Magnats, and I don't know why. I love more those R-ribbon highs from my Magnats than these tweeters. They are titanium tweeters, completely titanium tweeters, so they have to be good, you know. This one is a little bit, you can see, but the sound is the same as the other one, so it doesn't matter. And well, if you want to hear these speakers, just go to my other video, the video I tested the speaker cables. You will hear the sound of these things, and well, maybe you like this sound. The bass is there, you know, it have bass, but I don't like the dynamic of these speakers. And well, it can be my ears. My ears are used to Magnats for 23 years now, and well, maybe that's the reason. Maybe I heard them too long and it is difficult to step over to another speaker. I don't know why all these speakers sounds bad to me. Yeah. Okay, in my basement I have ASV Cantius 4, and those speakers are very, very good. They are white ones, and I already have them for a few months, so it's time for me to test them. Maybe those speakers will sound better. I have Magnat 07. I just bought them, so they are still upstairs. They are big, and well, they have to replace my Magnat 05 for a while, until I find a woofer, you know, and because this woofer is blown up and I need a new woofer inside, and well, maybe the 07 will sound better. I doubt that they sound better than my 05s, but okay, I will keep them for a while. They are ugly speakers, but well, all the speakers are working, so I will put them in place of my Magnat 05s. But the GBLs, the TI-600, I saw them on the market, on the Dutch market. The guy was selling them for €450. He has a business in speakers, in the receivers, the amplifiers, speakers, everything. He sells everything. DP stereo in I don't know, somewhere in the east of the Netherlands. This guy is crazy. He asked for these speakers, these GBLs, €450. Well, €450, that's a lot of money for the sound coming out of these things. So I sold them. Tomorrow this guy is coming to buy them for me, and I sold them for €75, and I think that's very cheap. I think 75 is a little bit too cheap. I think I can easily ask 125 for these speakers when I have the patience, but I don't have the patience. I need the money to buy other equipment to test them out. So, and I simply don't have the room for it. I don't have the room in my house for all these speakers. I have speakers in my basement for a few months now, and I didn't have time to test them out yet. And I have speakers everywhere. Look here. I have here the Wavdells. I still have to test them out. The Linton XP3. These are classical speakers. I have everywhere speakers. Upstairs I have even more speakers, and well, it's time for me to do some speaker tests, and I start with this GBL. When you compare it with the sound of my Magnat 05, like I told you, it's no comparison at all. My Magnats beat these GBLs by big lengths, and well, they are looking much nicer than these Magnats. I will be honest, the looks, the aesthetic looks of these GBLs, they are terrific. And if the fronts are, well, if the fronts are without any damage like this one, then it is a really nice combination. Really strong build, strong wooden, massive build quality, and strong metal frame for the speaker cloud, and it's good. The building quality is nothing wrong with it, but The sound is for me not sharp enough. The highs are not sharp enough. The bass is not low enough. 40 hertz. I told you before, a good speaker start at 32 hertz. Yes, because I don't use subwoofers. You know, there are guys who like to work with subwoofers. I don't like that. I want the bass from my speakers original. And these speakers, these GPLs with 40 hertz, well, you need a subwoofer. And with my Magnats, I don't need a subwoofer. These things start, some subwoofers don't even start at 30 hertz. And my Magnats start at 30 hertz. And the Magnats 07 I have upstairs, they start at 25 hertz. So I will test them maybe tomorrow, I don't know. Anyway, if you plan to buy these speakers, well, you can buy them just for a while, test them out, you know, play a little bit with them, and but don't expect a perfect sound, a good a sound you will fall in love with, because they don't have that quality. The price, the new price, who would believe you that these speakers are very good, because 900 euro in 1989 is a lot of money. And if you see what you can buy nowadays for 900 euro, well, you can buy pretty good speakers. Although I don't know if they are good, because I didn't test them out yet. I read in all these test magazines, these online testers, these big guys, you know. They all say, ah, good sounding, perfect sounding, good price quality, you know, and everything is good. Always, you know, I am honest to you guys. I am honest to you. If you are you follow my videos, you see, I'm always telling the truth. I'm not going to lie, because I don't make money, you know. I don't have a deal with GBL. They pay me money if I give a good review. Okay, these things are not in the shop anymore, so it doesn't matter. But for second hand, if you were my friend and you would ask me, hey, I saw some GBL's TI-600 on eBay, and this guy only asked 150 euros, should I buy them? I say, no, you can buy them for 50. 7 or 75 euro. That's what they worth in my eyes, in my ears. They are worth 75 euro. And I also sell these things for 75 euro. I don't think they are worth one penny more than 75 euros. And well, if you want to take the risk and you see these speakers and you think, oh, they are nice, I'm gonna buy them. And don't tell me I didn't warn you, you know, because really, maybe you missed my video, but okay, if you see this video and you're still gonna buy them, it's all on your risk, you know. They have some body, but hey, come on, 40 hertz, they start with 40 hertz, and you can hear that. And so if you love bass, don't start with these speakers, or you have to combine them with a subwoofer. But also the highs are missing some sharp quality. I missed those all ribbon tweeters from my Magnat. Really, I'm not happy with these speakers. Even my most beloved receiver, the Marantz 2238B, cannot let these speakers sing. Really, these speakers, I don't know what they need. I don't know. I test them with two amps. This one and a smaller Luxman from 2x40, but I have to test those things of those amplifier later. Anyway, the sound, really, I miss this Al Ribbon 34,000 hertz tweeters from this Magna. This only goes to 20,000 hertz, and the woofers start with 40 hertz, and that's not good. My viewers, really, believe me, if you ever see these speakers and you think, okay, they look good, because they look good, I'm sure your wife would like them, but believe me, sound wise they doesn't sound like they are looking. And ending this review, well, I hope I make all you guys a little bit wiser again. with this one review about this JBL TI-600 speakers. More speaker reviews will come soon on this channel, so please stay tuned, and for now I say bye bye.